Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh.
Children, have you ever have a doubt? A wooden boat in a water will float and a needle will sink. Why does it happen? Let us study in detail about the water density. Yes, because of water density, the things will float and some things will sink in the water. Yes, this works because of Archimedes' principle of bouncing. Archimedes' principle indicates that the upward buoyant force that is exerted on a body immersed in a fluid, whether fully or partially submerged, is equal to the weight of the fluid that the body displaces. Because the reason that ship floats is that it displaces a lot of water. This displaced water wants to return to its original location where the ship is now, and this pushes the ship upwards. The force which pushes the ship up is called buoyancy force. Archimedes continued to do more experiments and came up with a buoyancy principle that a ship will float when the weight of the water it displaces equal the weight of the ship, and anything will float if it is shaped to display its own weight of water because it reaches the point where it will submerge. This kind of a technical way of looking at it, a ship is launched, sinks into the sea until the weight of the water it displaces is equal to its own weight. As the ship is loaded, it sinks deeper, displaying more water, and so the magnitude of the buoyant force continuously matches the weight of the ship and its cargo. But a needle light as leaf, thin as pin, will sink right in. Why does it happen? Let us see. The density of a needle is mucher rather than the water, so it sinks easily. The weight of the water displaced by the ship is equal to its weight, so it floats. Whereas the weight of the water displaced by an iron nail is lesser than its weight, so the iron nail sinks. Children, have you seen that some things float on water while others sink? So think how this happens. Children, now let us discuss why does ice float in water. Each water molecule is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. The bonds between water molecules are called hydrogen bonds. As water cools up to 3.98 degrees centigrade, its mass stays the same but volume decreases. As the mass fits into a smaller space, so it is more compact. When water freezes at 0 degrees centigrade, the mass stays the same but its volume expands by 9%. In the liquid water, molecules are attracted to each other and temporarily held together by hydrogen bonds. When water freezes at 0 degree centigrade, a rigid open means like a web of hydrogen bonds molecules is formed. It is this open structure that ice makes less dense than water liquid. This is why icebergs float. Let us discuss why does a lemon float in salty water. When salt is dissolved in water, as it is in ocean water, that dissolved salt adds to the mass of the water and makes the water denser rather than it would be without salt. Because objects float better on a dense surface, they float better on a salt water and fresh water. children, now let us discuss why do things float in salt water. The fact that seawater has salt dissolved in it makes things more able to float in it. The salt in seawater causes it to weigh more percent unit volume than fresh water. The higher weight causes salt water to have a higher density, as density is directly related to the mass of the substance. Because of this reason, things float in salt water. Thank you.